Praise the Lord, my brothers and sisters. Our passage for today is taken from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, verses 52 to 59. I will read it for you. The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" So Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. So those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever." He said these things while he was teaching in the synagogue at Capernaum. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters, to understand this passage, we have to go back to the beginning of chapter 6, where Jesus feeds the 5,000 people with loaves and fish. After that, the people kept looking for Jesus. Then Jesus tells them, "You are looking for me only because you ate your full of the loaves. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you." Then the people asked Jesus, "What sign are you going to give us so that we may see it and believe in you? Our ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness." Then Jesus tells them, "It was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." They said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness and they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that anyone who eats of it may not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh." Now, after hearing this, the Jews were very confused. How can this man give us his flesh to eat? But the Lord was referring to his body, which was battered, bruised and broken on the cross and offered to his Father for the salvation of mankind. The previous day, at the Last Supper, he had instituted the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist. He took the bread, gave thanks to his Father, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat of this. Is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Then he took the cup of wine and giving thanks, he gave it to them saying, "Drink from it, all of you, for this is the blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins." My friends, we know that the Holy Eucharist is the source and summit of Christian life. We know that this Holy Eucharist is celebrated at some part of the world 24/7, and all of us can partake of the body and blood of Jesus. How many of us really take advantage of this? We as Christians can partake of the Holy Eucharist and partake of the body and blood of Jesus right after our first Holy Communion. But how many of us really take advantage of this? We know that we as humans work for our physical needs of food, shelter, and clothing. But what are we doing to satisfy our spiritual hunger? The Lord says, "My flesh is true food and my blood is true drink." So let us partake of this Eucharist and get nourishment from the Lord Himself. Then the Lord also says that those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me and I in them. Again in John 15:5, the Lord says, "Those who abide in me and I in them will bear much fruit, for apart from me you can do nothing." Yes, indeed we know that without the Lord we are nothing and we can do nothing. The Lord promises us eternal life. All for all those who partake of His body and blood sacramentally in a worthy manner with reverence, the Lord is waiting for each one of us to take advantage of this sacrament of the Holy Eucharist. My friends, we know that during this pandemic, our churches have been closed and we are not able to attend the Holy Eucharist. As soon as this pandemic is over and our churches are open to all of us, let us take advantage of this time and partake of the Holy Eucharist, receive the body and blood of our Lord. For the Lord promises eternal life to all of us who believe in Him and who trust in Him. Amen.